Hey guys, Jack 101 Star here. Welcome back to another reaction, and tonight we'll be reacting to Grace by Jeff Buckley. But this time, I'm not alone reacting. Alright, come on out, or say your name.
Hi, people.
Yep, I brought...
Jack. Awesome, Jack.
Yes, I found someone else named Jack. Yes, somehow. This is him right here.
Hi, people.
Hello, so...
Also Oscar the Tiger 2005 on YouTube as well.
I'll post a link to his channel description. So, anyways, you're just as big as a music nerd as I am, so I'm very ready for this.
Yeah.
Let's get a little more information on Jeff Buckley real fast, because this is a real interesting thing we have here.
Yeah, musician.
Yes. According to Wikipedia, Jeffrey Scott Buckley, raised as Scott Moorhead, was an American musician. After decades as session guitarist in Los Angeles, Buckley amassed a moderate following in the early 1990s, performing at venues at East Village, Manhattan, such as Sin E. After rebuffing interest from record labels and Herb Cohen, the manager of his father, singer Tim Buckley, he signed with Columbia, recruited a band, and released his only studio album, Grace, in 1994. So yeah, this is his only album since, unfortunately, 3 years later, Jeff Buckley would pass away. I think he drowned in a lake or something.
Yeah, he drowned in a lake at a wolf. I think the river is called Wolf Creek, I think.
Yeah, really unfortunate, because we could have got more music from this guy.
It was the summer of 1995, I believe. He was about to record his second album, but he died before he can do that, unfortunately.
Yeah, really unfortunate stuff. So that's why we're gonna react to this album, because apparently it's really good, despite only being his only album. Now, I did originally what is it?
Sorry, keep talking.
No, wait, you go first.
All right. So the song called Hallelujah,
I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna be
song of the original cover.
I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna grab my water. Keep talking.
All
right.
Anyway, the Hallelujah little background history. Jeff Buckley made the song more famous.
Oh, he did?
For the original cover. Yeah.
That's really interesting.
This is the only reason Hallelujah got famous more because of him.
Oh, I can't see your webcam now.
I kind of see your face.
Well, what do you know?
Yeah.
I actually did originally do a reaction to this. I posted about this on my community tab. Most of the videos muted for some reason. I have no control over that. It just didn't do it for some reason. Anyways, enough talking. I think we should get into this.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Let's do this. Let's do this. Grace, Jeff Buckley. Here we go. Huh. Track number one, Mojo Pin. You can hear it, right?
Yes, I do. I hear like a faint guitar sound.
Okay, perfect.
Like a high pitch violin or guitar.
Okay. Sorry to pause, but I didn't expect his voice to sound like that. Based on that cover, that cover art.
Oh, yeah.
It's really interesting.
His voice is really gorgeous.
Yeah, it is. Holy crap.
This is not my first time listening to Jeff Buckley, actually.
Oh, is it?
No, my first time listening to the songs was actually Hallelujah, and I think it's another song as well. I don't remember.
All right.
Is it quiet on your end?
What do you mean?
I don't know. It sounds really quiet on my end. I'm not too sure.
Let me turn the volume up on Spotify a bit. Better?
Okay, there we go. Much better. Yep, much better.
Get up my side. Wouldn't need no more joke.
Yeah.
This is actually really good, actually. I didn't expect this, to be honest.
Yeah.
Emotional. His voice has so much emotional to it.
I know. I should say, this first track is 5 minutes.
Memories fly, the rhythms fall slow. The beauty of love's soul.
Now what the? Oh my god.
Of opinion down my back, it's so
Oh my god. That, what a way to start.
Wow.
Yeah, what a way to start. Oh my.
Boris will have a lot of emotional to it. Oh wow.
I know. Like I didn't expect his voice at all to sound like that. I will admit. I thought it was gonna be a little bit more masculine, but still I like.
Yeah, like metal almost.
Yeah, kind of. Judging by the album cover only. Yeah. Oh my god.
Yeah.
Yeah, most of these songs are actually pretty long. At least 5 minutes for most of them.
At least it's not like 15 minutes.
Pink Floyd listeners.
Some songs. Yeah, like me.
Exactly. Oh man, that was a good track. I cannot wait to hear more of this.
Yeah, same.
Alright, anyways, track number 2 and title track, Grace. Okay.
Oh, I said I like the guitar sounds.
Oh yeah, I do too, actually. I love this so far.
Hey, this is actually really good.
And Jack has somehow magically transported to his bed.
I wrote it on my bed already.
Oh, that's funny. I love that. This is awesome. Oh my god. Oh my god.
Wow.
Yeah. Oh my god, that was amazing.
I know, right?
It's nearly the end of the year, and somehow that's one of the best songs I've heard on this channel.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
What do you think of him?
Sorry, what?
So what do you think of him?
Really good so far, because, oh my god. Yeah, his vocals are certainly not what I expected, but that's definitely not a bad thing.
I know. Plus, in Hallelujah, it has so much war emotion to it, too, as well.
Well, I can't wait to cross that bridge when we get to it. Oh, man.
Yeah, it plus is an epic guitar solo, too, as well.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, you'd be very surprised. Yeah.
That title track, oh my god.
I know.
Oh my. I'm not over that. Oh my god. Anyways, track number 3, Last Goodbye. Okay.
it's over. You gave me mortal for more than you'll ever know. Grace, must I dream and always see your face? Maybe
this reminds me a lot of Nick Drake. For some reason. Kind of reminds me of a Nick Drake song for some reason. Even though Nick...
Interesting. Never heard of him.
Even though he never used, like, traditional... He never did, like, rock. He did, like, traditional, like, folk stuff. Just the violins kind of reminded me of it a bit.
Oh, wow. Nice.
Dude, how is it this good? How is it this good already?
I don't know. So, yeah, I forgot to mention that this song is also pretty good here as well.
You've heard this before?
Yeah, only this song and the other song.
We're only on track 3. How is it this good?
I know. Rich is still alive, though.
Yeah, all right, let's resume. Once again, really great.
I know. I'm shocked of this.
I am too, kind of. Oh, assess me, turn up the volume of my computer. I gotta figure out how to mute that.
Yeah.
Wait, you can hear that too? Yeah, this is not a normal style I use for doing this. So, I apologize if the music's too loud. I apologize if my voice is too loud or too low or his. I never do stuff like this, so this is all experimental.
Oh, this is your first time doing something like this?
Yeah, that's why I did countless sound tests before this.
Oh, makes sense.
Oh, man, yeah, that song was good. How's it this good? That second track is still wild to me.
I know.
Oh, man, let's get back to it. Track number 4, Lilac Wine. I lost myself on a cool, damp night. Ooh.
Wow. I like that.
I do, too.
I already love this song already.
I know!
His voice has so much character to it.
I know. See what I want to see. I drink much more than I ought to drink. Oh, important thing to note. I just looked on Wikipedia. This is a cover.
Oh, okay.
It was originally written by James Shelton in 1978.
Interesting.
I did not know that.
I feel like 1978 has really good music for that year.
Yeah,
in my opinion.
Yeah, it does. It does actually.
Yeah, a little off topic. Like an hour ago, I was listening to some songs. I didn't realize, but these two songs I was listening to was actually released since 1978. So yeah.
Oh wow!
In case you're wondering, one of them is by Journey and Tuda. I'm not sure how to pronounce it.
Interesting. All right, back to it.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Lilac wine.
I feel. Listen to me. I cannot see clearly. Isn't that she coming? Sweet and heady. Where's my love? Listen to me. Why is everything so hazy? Like wine, I feel. I'm ready. For my love. my god. Wow. Yeah, wow. Oh my god. How's
I have
he...
no words.
I have no words either.
It's almost... Yeah, this is almost sounding like this one artist named Lord Heron. He made similar music to this.
Oh, really?
I highly recommend listening to his song. Yes. So he started around 2010. His famous song is called The Night We Met. It's about love and romantic music, stuff like that.
Oh, cool. Let's see. I'm trying to look for...
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Anyways, I'm trying to look for, like, it's...
Let me spell it for you.
Inspiration. What was Jeff Buckley's inspiration? It sounds like a lot like something that Nick Drake would do. Oh, right. You guys can hear Discord notifications.
Yeah, sorry about that.
That's fine.
Because I want to make chaos.
Lord Huron. Okay, I'll keep that in mind.
Yeah. I will give you some recommendation songs.
That's good.
And albums. So, yeah.
Very, very nice. Hold on. Let's go to Jeff Buckley album. So, can't really find any, like, inspirations on Wikipedia. Maybe I'm just not looking hard enough. Anyways, let's watch track number 5, So Real.
His voice just sounds so real.
I know. It's so real, I think.
Oh, yeah.
That too. Okay. This sounds really eerie.
I know. Oh, wow.
Yeah. I'm sorry, I never stepped on the cracks because I thought I'd hurt my mother.
Wait, what just happened?
And I never stepped on cracks because I thought I'd hurt my mother. That's kind of funny.
That is so...
It's oddly corny coming from him.
Yeah.
Eh, whatever. Oh my god! I'm sorry, you're being muffled by the music. What did you say?
I was gonna say that the same thing.
I was being muffled too?
I don't know.
Oh god, that just came out of nowhere. What the heck?
Yeah.
Let's continue this.
Yeah.
Doink.
Oh god, it gets horrible.
Yeah, what the heck? I love you. This reminds me of a Slint song.
I know.
Oh my god. Oh my god, is
wow.
Yeah, wow indeed. That's like the seventh wow in a row because oh my god.
I know, I don't know what other terms than wow, so I'm sorry if we kept saying wow.
Oh, don't worry, I recap the same words all the time on my channel.
Yeah. I would say, wow, that was really good. I have no words.
Yeah, I had no idea Jeff Buckley's voice could go that high. What the heck?
I know. That was like a soprano, I think.
Oh, wow.
I don't know.
Oh, man. All right. You ready for... All right. Yeah, you've listened to this next one. You already know what it is.
Yeah.
Track number 6.
Yeah, not the whole song. Not the whole song, but yeah, this song is really good.
All right. All right. Track number 6, Hallelujah. Originally by Leonard Cohen. Oh, this is the longest one out here. This is nearly 7 minutes.
Yeah.
Sorry, it sounds nice.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I heard there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do you? Lift the minor fall and the major lift. The baffled king. Hallelujah. Her kitchen chair, and she broke your throne, and she cut your hair, and from your lips she drew the hallelujah.
This sounds nice.
I know.
In this room, and I've walked this floor, you know. I used to live alone before I knew you. Broken hallelujah, hallelujah.
unrelated. I just figured out why your webcam kept cutting out. It's because I kept on closing out the specific tab.
Oh. So what happened?
Sometimes in a video, your webcam just does not show at all. I just figured out I had to hover over the tab with Spotify on it in Discord just to show your webcam. So most of the video, your webcam's just blocked out.
No.
And every breath we drew is hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh, here's something cool. According to Wikipedia, on the 2nd of April 2013, it was announced that Buckley's version of the song will be inducted into the Library of Congress's National Recording Registry.
Oh, wow.
So, yeah, it was that.
Wait for 2013 to come.
Yeah, me neither. I love how you're just in your bed now. You're just laid down.
Yeah.
That is being shown, by the way.
Get comfy for this.
Of course.
Huh?
Of course.
Wait, what happened?
All I just said was, of course.
And it's not a cry that you hear at night. It's not somebody who's seen the light. It's a cold and it's a
Jesus Christ. Thanks, Jeff Buckley. You scared me. Not the first time that song's done that to me. First it was Suggestions by Fugazi. Yeah, that was great.
Yeah, that was really good. So what do you think of it?
Yeah, that was good. I don't know if it had to be 7 minutes though, but still, that was good.
I know. I haven't listened to this song in a while, so yeah.
Oh, cool. Very good. Alright, let's, yeah, that was good. We have five tracks left. We're halfway through. Let's take like a quick 15-minute intermission, you think?
Sure.
All right, come back 15 minutes. We'll finish the album.
All right. Wait. Is my face in there or no?
Hold on. There's your face.
Yay.
That's really weird. I could also see Discord on it for some reason. Wait, how's that possible?
Mm.
That's Spotify. Whoops. What is going on? We're lost. Oh, wait. I need to click on your thing again. Okay, we're good. We fixed the problem.
Yay.
Problem fix.
Oh, God.
Okay.
Oh, that's not good.
What is?
I just turned on my phone, and how the screen just turned green.
Oh, God.
Let me show you.
I would say get a new phone. Hold on.
Hold on, do you see it?
Why does it keep going to Spotify? Somehow it keeps redirecting to Spotify. Hold on.
I know.
All right, show it again.
All right, hold on. See that white?
Yeah.
We turn off.
Oh. Yeah. Oh, God.
My touch screen's not working.
Not good.
Oh, no. Oh, God. It's freaking out.
Oh, God.
I'm going to lose 500. I'm going to lose all my notes and photos.
Oh, God.
I'm a songwriter, and I don't want to lose my songs.
Copy paste them all over to Google Docs, if you can.
Okay. It's on the iPhone notes, though. How do I do it?
I think you could share it to Google Drive.
I'll try it too. I'll have over 2,000 notes.
Oh my God. Anyway.
If I lose all my notes, I'm gonna cry.
Oh God.
Okay, let's just, yeah.
Alright, are we ready to continue?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, what's your favorite one so far?
I have to guess it is, Lilac Wine or...
Lilac Wine. Yeah, probably, title track. Title track's definitely my favorite. All right, yeah, another 7-minute one coming up next. Let's move on to track number 7, Lover, You Should Have Come Over.
Wait, are you recording this?
Yes.
Okay, good.
Interesting.
That sounds familiar, I don't know why.
Interesting instrument.
I know.
Why'd that make me jump, Jesus?
Happened.
I just jumped for a moment.
Weird. All I did was getting comfy in my bed.
Parading in the wake of sad relations as their shoes fill up with water.
Ooh.
To keep good love from going wrong. Broken down and hungry. For your love, but no way to feed it.
Ooh. You know what this reminds me of? This reminds me of a Radiohead song, actually. It's exit music for a film.
Oh, wow. That, yeah, it kind of does.
Yeah, that would come 6 years later, though, but it gives me that same vibe for some reason.
I mean, Radiohead did come out in 1992, I think.
I think you're right on that.
Yeah, it was. Okay. 1991 and 1992. Okay, let's keep going.
He said the thing. He just said the thing.
What?
He said the thing. He said the thing.
But the title.
Yes, he said the thing. Oh my god. That was, once again, really good.
Yeah.
That was really good. I can't believe his vocals could even go up that high in the first place.
I know.
Oh my god.
Especially this one artist that's named James Taylor? No, James...
James Taylor?
Start with... No, not James Taylor. There's a song called You're Beautiful by James something. I don't remember. His voice is super high on that.
Oh, interesting.
His voice in general.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll have to see that. Maybe I'll have to look that up someday, but still, that track was good.
I know.
I don't know why. I love some of, like, I love some of the melodies on it.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Anyways, track number 8, Corpus Christi Carol.
69.
Oh, it's actually the shortest one on here. It's only under 3 minutes. Speaking of high vocals, oh my god.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, oh my god.
Oh my. I did not expect how high that voice is.
Yeah, me neither. Oh my god.
Oh my days.
Yeah.
And it was hanged with gold so red. And on this bed that lieth the night, his wound is bleeding day. By his bedside standeth a stool.
Corpus Christi's in Texas, if you're wondering.
Ah.
City in Texas.
Ah. Oh my god, it's getting higher.
I know, that's the end of the song, though. That was surprising. Yeah. That was surprising. Oh, wow.
That is the most highest vocal I ever heard on that album.
Yeah. From a male singer, I think. Besides that one really weird Smith song, was a miserable lie.
Yeah.
His
high pitched voice sound like those high. I don't know what I'm trying to say.
opera.
Yeah. Opera, yeah, that's what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, holy crap. I didn't expect it to go up that high.
I know.
I was just talking about how high his vocals could go. We were just doing talk. Oh my gosh. Anyways, track number 9, Eternal Life. Very biblically titled ones.
Yeah.
Okay.
I sound like a little country.
Yeah, country, definitely.
Western music.
Yeah. Oh my god.
Wow.
Okay, a ninth track here. We actually have a proper rock song, it sounds like.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
We got into the music only 30 seconds, and a lot of stuff happened.
Yeah, what the heck? Not now, Jesus Christ, I just had a McAfee notification pop up. Apparently it's the right time for-
I heard it.
Apparently it's the right time for McAfee to tell me that my antivirus expired.
That's lovely.
I guess so. Oh, it's like.
We didn't expect that.
Yeah, actually, like proper rock song for once. I feel like.
Oh. I know, this just feels so different after the last
eight
few songs he did.
Yeah, the last
eight.
Oh my god! Yeah, that was great.
I know.
Anyways, on to our 10th and second to last track, Dream Brother.
Wait, this the last song? Wait, no, this is not the last.
Second to last. Interesting.
I know.
This is interesting.
Oh, yeah.
This is different somehow. This is interesting. Sounds very tribal.
Thank you.
This is very, like, tribal, I feel like. Whoa. Interesting once again.
Interesting.
Yeah.
I like we just both said it.
Yeah, pretty much. Like, oh, wait, not yet. Okay, let's just take that in first before we move on to the last one. Oh my god. Yeah, that was definitely different from everything else, I'd say.
I know.
Besides Corpus Christi Carol. Yeah, that was very interesting. It sounded more, like, atmospheric. Kind of reminded me of, like, I don't know what... Kind of reminded me of something. More psychedelic, I'd say.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Anyway,
I noticed the little error with the lyrics, too, I think.
Yeah, Spotify lyrics aren't too... Sometimes they don't catch up, sometimes they say the wrong thing, sometimes.
Yeah.
It started catching up at the last second.
Yeah.
Oh, man. We have one track left.
Yeah, but then at the end we can give our opinions out.
Yes. Anyways, on to our 11th and final track, Forget Her. 5 minutes to end off, because why wouldn't it be? Okay. Dropping a petal in the world before her. Was sober with no. Don't fool yourself. She was hard. This is beautiful. Now that's a good use of the fade out right there.
Yeah.
That was a powerful song.
I know.
Oh my god. And that was the album. That was Grace by Jeff Buckley. Oh man.
I have no words.
I'm gonna give this a 9. That's a 9.
Yeah, I'd say a 9.1 for me.
Ah, very nice. Let's see, I'll go first. Top 3 were Grace, Hallelujah, and Forget Her. What were your top 3?
So my top 3 is... Wait, let me see the song tracks.
Oh, yeah. Give me a moment.
It was Let Tech Wine, Last Goodbye, and Grace.
Yeah, if I had to choose a favorite, I'd probably choose Grace.
Yeah.
Least favorite?
Grace is such a good song.
It was. Least favorite, I would probably do Corpus Christi Carol. It wasn't much, but... Yeah. Or maybe Mojo Pin. Those weren't much, but still good vocals.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
His voice is so high.
I know. If only we got to hear more from him.
I know. Sucks that he passed away too soon.
I know.
I can now understand why he was such a legendary.
I know. And he does have a compilation. There is a compilation released of unreleased songs by him. Maybe we'll get to that someday. Who knows?
Yeah, he knows. But yeah,
That was a great album.
Such talent, wow.
I know, yeah. Such talent.
So glad I listened to it.
I know, I'm glad I did for a second time.
Yeah.
I didn't really remember a lot in the first.
My first time.
I don't really remember a lot on the first go, so I'm glad I did this again.
Yeah.
Anyways, yeah. That'll be it for tonight. Thank you guys for joining us on this reaction.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for, I can speak today.
It's fine. Anyways, I'm Jack 101 Star.
And this is Jack Kalasa 2.
And we'll see you guys next time. Bye.
Yes. Bye-bye.